Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's a privilege to be coming your way again today. I'm very sure that God will bless you. It will impact your life positively, even as you listen to what I'm about to share with you today. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory and praise. Thank you for your word that is coming today. I know it will be a great blessing. Be exalted in Jesus' name. Cause our hearts to receive revelation from your word today. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to especially appreciate every one of you that have been subscribing to this channel. Those of you that are following me on Facebook, on Instagram, Stephen.Orioye.Olakunle on Instagram, Stephen Olakunle on Facebook, while on YouTube, Gospiration Power Television, TV. I know your lives have been blessed. God bless you again and again. Today, I want to share with you very quickly on the testimony of Jesus. Wow. The testimony of Jesus. I'll read from Revelation chapter 19. Revelation 19, verse 10. It says, "And I fell at his feet to worship him. And he said unto me, See thou do it not." Don't do it. Don't do it. "I am thy fellow servant and of thy brethren that have the testimony of Jesus." I have the testimony of Jesus. I'm a fellow servant, a servant that has the testimony of Jesus. Worship God, for the testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. The testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. You have been reading it, especially in the book of Revelation. You see it in different parts. This phrase is mentioned, the testimony of Jesus, the testimony of Jesus, the testimony of Jesus. Today, you will understand what the testimony of Jesus means from the Bible. The word testimony in the Hebrew language means do it again. The word that is translated as testimony in English language, in the Hebrew, it means do it again. Do it again. So what is testimony? Testimony is a way of bringing something to pass again, like as it has already been done, as we proclaim it. As we proclaim it, as we proclaim it. Testimony is not a show off. Testimony is not a show off. It is rather the creation of a platform for it to be repeated. It's the creation of a platform of the very thing to be repeated. So it is not and will never be a show off. We take testimonies in church. We hear testimonies. We read testimony. It's not a show off. It is a platform that is created for it to be repeated. Because the word testimony from the Hebrew language means do it again. So whenever testimony comes up, it is telling us something that can be done again. You will understand better as I continue in this analysis. There is the gift of prophecy in the Bible and in Christendom, in life in general. There is the spirit of the gift of prophecy. And what is the gift of prophecy? It is the grace. Gift means grace, because it is translated from the Greek word that is called, that means gifts and grace. Charismata, 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 or charis, charis. It means gift or grace. So A testimony is the grace to say, the gift of prophecy is the grace that we receive with which we are able to say things that will surely come to pass. The gift of prophecy is the grace that we receive with which we are able to say things that will surely come to pass as inspired by the Holy Spirit. As inspired by the Holy Spirit, we say things that will surely come to pass. That is what we call prophecy, or the gift of prophecy. The gift of prophecy is the grace that comes upon you that makes you able to say things that will surely come to pass as you are inspired by the Holy Spirit. There is what we call prediction in this world. There is prediction, which is just a guesswork. Guess, you're guessing. Maybe two clubs or countries are playing a match, maybe a football, Nigeria versus Ghana, maybe England versus Netherlands. They are playing, and you say, okay, this one we beat the other one in the match, maybe 2-0 or 2-1, like we predict them and the way we think them to be. That one is prediction. Sometimes these things, predictions, come to pass, like economic prediction that there will be inflation in certain country at a particular time. The dollar will rise, dollar will fall. All of these things are what? Predictions. They are guesswork, they are assumption that comes as a result of what we know, or the things we have already seen, or the trend that things are going, the particular way of things at a particular time will make us be able to predict something. That if Eimba, which is a football club in Nigeria, is to play against Barcelona or Chelsea, we can predict it that Chelsea will beat them hands down in the match because of what we already know, because of the situation or thing with the club at a particular time. So that is what we call prediction. So prediction is different from prophecy. Many people don't know. Prophecy is the statements that are inspired by the Holy Spirit, which we make. We make statements as inspired by the Holy Spirit. Even the person prophesying himself does not even know how the thing will come to be, but is inspired, is overwhelmed by the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God takes over his consciousness, takes over his human senses to be able to say things that will surely come to pass without the hand of man in it. Even man, if you ask him, how can this thing be? We don't know, but it will be that the Spirit of the Lord is the one that has caused it to be said, and he will make it to happen. I pray God will give you wisdom. So there is the gift of prophecy, which I've explained, the grace you receive to be able to say things that will surely come to pass as inspired by the Holy Spirit. There is also what is called prediction, which is just a guesswork, an assumption, or an expectation. You just predict. That is prediction. People are confusing all of these things together today. They are calling prediction prophecy. They are calling prophecy prediction. Though prophecy has an amount of prediction in it, but it is strictly by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. It is not by any human calculation or human technology that you are trained of things. No. There is also what we call the spirit of prophecy. There is what we call the spirit of prophecy. I've written a book on who is a prophet. You see some of these things explained in detail in depth, as God will give you grace to get. The spirit of prophecy is when the Holy Spirit gives us an encouragement through the things or words that are being said or spoken. The spirit of prophecy is different from the gift of prophecy. The gift of prophecy is the grace that you are given to be able to say things that will surely come to pass as inspired by the Holy Spirit. While the spirit of prophecy is when the Holy Spirit gives one gives you or gives me an encouragement through the things that has happened, the things that have happened, or through the words that have been spoken. When you receive encouragement from what you are hearing, what has happened that you are now hearing or has happened in your presence, or what you are hearing somebody saying that it has happened to him or her, which can come in the form of testimony, that the spirit of prophecy comes at that time. It comes to give you an encouragement in that thing, that if this thing can happen to so and so, it can also happen to me. So when testimony is said in church, when people are giving their testimony, that is why it is important for people to tell their stories. Because many times, if they don't tell their stories, you don't hear their story, you will not be encouraged. Imagine that the stories that are written in the Bible were not written. If they were not written, we would not have the kind of encouragement that we have.